From WHYY in Philadelphia, this is Radio Times. I'm Artemas Cohen.
So Tuesday we have David Kilcullen.
Yeah.
Kilcullen's book has gotten very little review, but he's been all over the media. So It's, you know, it's a case where the person is more interesting than the book. There's nobody quite like him. He's an Australian 20-year military officer there who specialized in counterinsurgency. He started working, I guess, late 90s. He started working with U.S. forces, consulting with them. And so he played a key role, especially in framing the surge strategy. And then also, he's become a critic of where the Afghanistan policy has gone.
Your ears would have exploded.
This is your volume control on your headphones.
Yeah.
It should be about like that.
But just, benefits.
So when I put mine on, you can put yours on, and then we'll go.
So you were senior advisor to General Petraeus in Iraq.
Yeah, and then I came back and I was the special advisor to Secretary Rice.
Okay. Oh, yeah, Newsweek.
So, Paul, is there any glimmer of hope in these numbers?
He's basically saying we can't win.
Everyone agrees we should get out of it. There's no disagreement.
Yeah.
The question is, how stable do you have to make it before you get out? And how do you do that? Right. And can you do it in the time? You
know? 82 degrees in Center City, WHYY, 1006.
I'm Artemas Cohen. Welcome to Radio Times. World leaders, including Secretary of State Hillary Rodham Clinton, are meeting in Kabul, Afghanistan today for an international conference. The U.S. has been fighting an on-again, off-again war in Afghanistan for almost 9 years. The current strategy, including the deployment of more troops, is aimed at defeating the insurgency, strengthening the Afghan government, and bringing security to the Afghan people. Our guest, David Kilcullen, was a senior advisor to General David Petraeus in Iraq.
What are our American troops doing there right now, and how do we get them home, and how soon can we get them home to, withdraw?
Dorothy, I appreciate the call. Yes, go ahead, David Kilcullen.
Yeah, look, as I said a little bit earlier, I think counterinsurgency is not necessarily the best way to think about what we're doing in Afghanistan. I think it's more of a stability operation, and I think that the role of the military in this environment is to create a safe enough environment at the local level for local people that allows them to put the weapon down and start resolving some of these issues. It can only work in conjunction with a very strong anti-corruption and governance push.
Well, much more to talk about. David Kilcullen, I appreciate you joining us today on Radio Times. Thanks very much.
Thanks for having me.
You're very welcome. I'm Artemas Cohen. You're listening to WHYY-FM Philadelphia and WHYY.org, member-supported public media. Great. I have to go on the air in about 5 seconds, so just sit tight. I'll get you out. That was great.
Thanks.
Thank you very much. And then we have Debbie, sort of a two-parter then.
Yeah. Yes. So this is the story of this Iraqi interpreter, Safa Ismail, and he worked for the 416th Battalion in Iraq, and came to work every day despite the fact that his life was at risk. He was being chased down the street. He had to sleep with a gun under his bed. He had to change, his route to work every day, and saw other interpreters, having been executed and stuff like that. And then there was, after nearly dying in a car bomb explosion, he decided he had to leave Iraq. And with the help of these friends he'd made in the military, they helped him get asylum, actually the special visa, here in Philadelphia.
Well, these guys want to say hi to you.
Hi, how you doing, man? I want your car. Did you get a car?
I don't actually have one, but
I can call it. Here's
another chair.
I'm all about cool.
Yeah.
I'm still actively engaged.
What are you doing, man?
Hi, Safa. I'm Marty. Nice to meet you. We read about you in the Philadelphia Inquirer.
He was the commander of the 101st at that point.
Yeah.
He was the commander in Mosul when we arrived in Mosul.
I'm Marty Moscowane. Welcome back to Radio Times. The U.S. military has depended on Iraqi translators since the start of the war in 2003. And sadly, some of those interpreters have paid with their lives.
As we said before, he's in Philadelphia. Radio Times, what is your question or comment? Everywhere. He has
and just saying thank you is one thing, but you know, we'd like our callers to embellish a little bit.
Bob, two standing by, please.
Who?
Two.
Because all what we see in the media is people who are anti-American, people who are against, against democracy. So here, Safar, thank you again, Safar, for showing the true image of Iraqis who are fighting against terrorism, who are struggling for the Iraqi freedom, sacrificing their lives, and I'm so proud of you. Thank you very much.
Thanks for your nice words, Luma.
I mean, was there a turning point for you, Safar, where you said, this is just too dangerous?
One of my friends, who was an interpreter as well, her sister, who looked like her, was assassinated, mistaken her.
I remember that.
So I do have my younger brother who also looks like me, and not necessarily, it doesn't need to look like me to be known or as my brothers or family members. At that point, I decided that it would be enough for me and for my family first, not for me. My work, part of what I do, relates to translation, but in that field still, I wouldn't think that it would be worth it.
What's the kind of show that really makes you like your work?
This is so gorgeous, I think. This
oh, God, cool. Yes. I like that. My mother will start to worry. She's my favorite singer, Ella.
Oh, magnificent.
This is just so effortless. It's just beautiful.
We didn't want to let the summer get away without celebrating Frank Lesser's 100th birthday, which was in late June. Well, here with us in our Philadelphia studios is David Fox, our guest for part two of our summer series on musical theater. And David Fox, always a pleasure and always fun to talk about music.
Thanks for having me back. I love it.
Oh, well, we love it as well.
Your list, it's Amy. Ply her with bonbons.
Poetry. So, Bob, we'll probably fit in Sue Me before we go to the first break.
And tell him. Stand by. Hollanderize it.
Yeah. No, but you need all that you're...
Bob Balls, the engineer for today's edition of the show, which is produced by Susan Greenbaum, Patty Leswing, Dennis Devine, and Debbie Builder. I'm Marty Moscowane, and you're listening to WHYY-FM Philadelphia and WHYY.org, member-supported public media.